enfant des parcs, gamin des plages. Le vent menace les châteaux de sable façonnés de mes doigts. Le temps n'épargne personne, hélas. Les années passent, l'écho s'évade sur la dune du Pila. Au gré des saisons, des photomatons, je m'abandonne.
Good morning, this is Guillaume here at Clos Solène. We are on the top of Le Haut du Clos, which is the end of the property on the top of the hill. This spot is magical because you can see over 360 degrees. So I'm here this morning to kind of go through the spring release. It's a release of the spring of the wine 2019 and 2020 white and rosé. So I'm super pleased to kind of explain those wines. You know, we'll explain a little bit in a couple of minutes. But to kind of give you an overview right now, what we are doing, you know, we're just starting to preening the estate. As you know, we planted 10 acres in two phases, 18 and 19. And last year we had, you know, for 2 weeks, an awesome team to come and graft over the whole entire 10 acres. So now we have in production, starting for 2021, 10 new acres, which is going to give about, I would say, 10 to 12 tons. As you can see, if we go toward the vines, we just pruned. They look healthy, nice. We have a good trunk size. And the main reason of that size of the trunk and why how healthy that vine is after 2 years, just an FYI, we never have a crop before 3 years, 3 to 4. And the reason is because we really want to have a good establishment of the vine for the roots, the trunk size, to be able to host the varietal above and produce grapes. You know, if you do a little bit quicker, it might, you know, shorten the life of the vine. So we want to have that for the life of the vine, but also for the quality of the fruit, year three starting when they start to produce, like being really nice and healthy. Because if the vine is too weak, the fruit is going to be weak. So our goal is to have a healthy vine. And the reason how is it healthy is if we turn the camera over the grafting, so we can see this grafting was done. So the reason of the vine being healthy, it's for this case right here. I explained many times with you, and this step is so important for you to get, you know, the first phase of Clos Solène and how the quality of the fruit will be impacted in a good way to make the best one as possible. So here is a vine that was planted in 2019. So the size at the beginning was more something like this, you know, kind of very small. We plant this and we call that a rootstock, you know, and he has a root zone about 2 feet. And this root zone start to grow. And then the trunk, as he's starting to kind of planting, after a few months, he start to kind of grow roots. And, you know, after a year or two, the trunks change. So you clearly see this vine, the trunk changed from that size to this size in about 3 years matter. And when you have a strong a vine like this, that means the vine is really healthy, very like deep underground, like about 2 feet or 3 feet of roots, ready to pick up the graft. So at the nursery, we ask, you know, to have the vine in a rootstock like this. They don't look good, they grow ugly, they don't produce any grapes. And then about when the trunk is big enough, like I just explained, we actually are coming, we are going to actually shoot over the next vine. If you see this vine right here, it was grafted already. So last year we did, like I say, graft the whole thing. So which means we cut the rootstock, you know, we cut the head of this one. And we came and grabbed, you know, some budwood. Actually, we picked in different many good vineyards during the winter. And we kind of kept, you know, budwood that size, you know, about 5 buds. You know, bundle it in a newspaper, put it in the fridge at about 36 Fahrenheit. And we took it out during in the grafting season, which happened in May. So when you have a good budwood to graft, you can see, you know, you see when it's really green and giving water. So that's a good one. So that's actually budwood of Grenache. We went on a different, like I said, really, really good vineyard. And we took that budwood, take it out from the fridge, take one bud, basically like this, and make like a skirt like this. And we enroll on this, you know, tape, white tape, to kind of compress, and the sap, the only way to get out on the sap is to go on the bud, and it became a vine. So that's a vine that's a beautiful establishment, good size of the trunk, same as the trunk of the rootstock. And this one is going to produce at least 3 to 5 clusters, you know. So really happy to see that. That give me really kind of gone, really good long life for the vines, definitively. And our goal right now is to basically remove the tape, you know. The tape, when it's done its job, meaning like sealing the graft on the rootstock, or, you know, is basically to remove it, you know. We want to remove it to just to kind of have now the full control going to the graft. And now everything is connected beautifully from the bottom to the graft to the vine. And here we go. So we should have good fruit this year. All right, why don't we go taste some wine? And you know, this release is only for wine. We have the Hommage Blanc, the Rosé, the Fleur, and the Harmony. So let's go down and let's taste those wines. All right, we just went down from the Léo Duclos we were like just 2 minutes ago. So we just move here. This location is pretty special because it's kind of split up between, you know, the phase two, the young vine, you know, on the hill, and with the old vineyard. So right here, the reason I'm in the middle of those two parts is because it's actually a block of Roussanne, because we're going to talk about the Hommage Blanc. And the Hommage Blanc is Roussanne Viognier with a Grenache Blanc. And so the bottom part of this block is Roussanne. Why the bottom versus why not the top? What's good about the bottom, it has a little bit more dirt. It has a little bit more like things going on, and the top sometimes a little bit more exposed. And I'm really, really pleased we actually planted this about, you know, 1100 vines of Roussanne with some Grenache Blanc at the end. So that will go into production this year for the 2021 vintage. We should have, you know, should have maybe, I don't know, about a quarter of a ton to half a ton. So now we are going to shifting to the old vine. So the old vine, which is called the Vieille Vigne, where here when we bought the estate in 17, it's about 7 acres block on the front of the tasting room. Yeah, there's, you know, some hill definitively. And this old block, we're not doing so well. So what we did, we kind of cut the vine all the way to the ground and regrafted the varietal needed for our program, which is, you know, Syrah, Grenache, Roussanne Viognier, Mauvette, Cabernet, and some Syrah again at the end. So right now, talking about the Hommage Blanc, we have about 5 rows of Roussanne Viognier. Actually, you know, they are like co-planted. They are actually on the same row. You have those two together, and some little bit of other ones, like very minuscule amounts. And the 2020 vintage, we have about 20% of this fruit into a blend. I think 25%. The rest come from Jamesbury, just behind the hill, on the same type of soil. And after, another type of soil is limestone. It's coming from Glenrose. On Peachy Cannon Road, is coming from also Adelaida. So we have about 25% of each of those four vineyards. What I'm really happy about here is the fact when we pick, it was actually about 3 weeks after the rest. You know, a little bit cooler because we're on a Willow Creek, almost at the same time, actually after than Saxum. So you can really see the quality of the fruit on the wine that being picked later. It actually have a little bit more complexity, so I'm very, very pleased with that. All right, we just came back to the winery from the top of the vineyard. So we're going to actually talk about the rosé, you know, the 2020 rosé. So our goal on the rosé is to really take it seriously in a way that, you know, the color, the flavors, the acidity, and from that is no way around. We have to actually pick from blocks specifically to make rosé. You know, we pick them before ripeness to kind of reach this level of acidity and alcohol. But at the end, after 2 months of aging, before bottling, we had actually a little bit of bleeding that we took off from Grenache usually to kind of bring a little bit more texture to the blend. And that's about 10% of the blend. So the machine I'm actually in front of it makes all the work for the rosé. It's a press. If we look a little bit closer inside, we're going to see this bladder here. And this bladder actually helps the cluster, when we throw the cluster inside, to be pushed on the side against, you know, the wall, and out of the slot, the juice start to come off. You know, when we start to press, it has this kind of 3 different level of color. You know, it's very light when you're barely squeezing. it's a little bit darker. As we squeeze like halfway, you know, the machine go between 0 and 2 bar. So that's 0.1 bar, that's 1 bar, and that's 2 bar. You know, the 2 bar take all the juice out of the berries. And for the rosé, to be honest, it's a little bit too much. It's too tanniky. It's too colored. So this one, we actually don't take it. We actually throw it away. We kind of do between those two, and which means result of a lot of loss. But that's the best way to make actually the rosé the way it is. Very spicy, so I'm going to open it. On the glass, it's almost like white wine. The blend is about 60% Grenache, with about 15% Senso and some Mauvais and a little bit of Syrah. The Syrah just kind of brings some red fruits. The Senso actually make a big clusters. Does provide spiciness, juiciness onto the blend, and the Mauvais give you a little bit of a tannin, and the Grenache is give you just the fruit, you know. You know, I think it's really rich, the Closeline style on the nose. Super, I mean, so much things going on inside. Texture on the mid palate to the end. But again, the back of it really come back mineral, beautiful. I mean, that's, you know, rosé, don't be shy to kind of age also a little bit. You can drink in the next, 1 or 3 years. But yeah, I think you can actually age for 4 years. I opened a few 15. I was pretty surprised how well they taste. They're more round, but they're still beautiful, especially with the acidity. They also come in 3 liters and Magnum as well. So, you know, please ask. All right, this is red. So for the spring release, you are going to get 4 wine. You are going to get the white and rosé we just tried, the 2020. The 2 reds we are going to move into will be Harmony and Fleur. The Pinot we had in the past called Impreview, we didn't produce in 19 because we really want to focus on the estate fruits and our goal of doing those round wines. But it brings me a lot of disappointment for you guys because you love so much the Pinot. So I might do maybe the Pinot 1 year after another. I mean, it'd be like very special allocated. And so we'll talk about it. And the last one is Sweet Clémentine we usually have in spring. 2019, we actually got a small issue, and you know, issue happen always with winemaking. You know, the Sweet Clémentine is made with Grenache. You know, it's actually our dessert wine. And when we do actually this wine, we let the Grenache ferment all to actually meet fermentation. And at that time, we bring brandy. The brandy actually killed the yeast, stop the fermentation. And the wine is pretty much made. You know, we do a couple more tricks behind the barrels, the, you know, in the mast. But in 19, what happened is the fermentation stopped, and then we were busy with all the rest, and the fermentation restarted. I don't know how. And so it happened sometime. And so the fermentation went through and all the way through, and the wine actually was not possible to make because this one is with about 100 grams of sugar per liter, which is about 10%. So unfortunately, we won't have this one in 19. But it's always great to make mistake because you know that the year after, you're really more cautious, more careful. That's what it is. So unfortunately, we won't have any of those. The one thing on the Sweet Clémentine 18 and the Impreview, the Pinot 18, we kept some aside just because of those issues. Like that, if you guys want some, absolutely you can take some. So don't be shy to ask the winery and ask for the previous vintage because we kept some for you guys just to make sure we can, you know, fulfill your wish. So the one I have right now is a Fleur de Soleil 19. The vintage 19 was actually a super vintage. The weather was super, we got some rain, the growing season was perfect, and also the harvest season was also super perfect. And that gears toward higher quality maturity, which means like not as hot, the acidity are not burned, the sugar rises slowly, and we can achieve something super elegant, you know. 2020, like I said, we got some heat wave and definitely get some acid off and things like that. But we were able to do it. But for 19, I would say put your hands on this vintage for anywhere in the world because it was stunning. Definitely complex, acid also, super acidic. And what I love about it, you know, is definitely this all these layers kind of bring into this wine. So the Fleur de Soleil is actually a wine that Solène dreamt to have on a portfolio. It's something soft, elegant. We started this one in 2008 with called Petite Solène, and then we shift toward Fleur de Solène in 2014. And because of this guy, you know, we kind of ship it from Italy, and we actually started to bring into the blend Cabernet Sauvignon, kind of bring more texture to it. That was a little bit missing, you know, because prior to that, with Petite Solène, it was only Syrah Grenache. So having the Cabernet into the equation, into the blend, makes the wine definitely more grip in the mid palate, more classiness. So, you know, if I smell that, definitely more red fruit, you know, pretty classic. The oak are present. This wine has about 40%, I think 35% new oak with a Cabernet in it. You know, we like to have it in new oak to kind of run it out. So definitely on a palate, I really feel 19 vintage. The attack is present. I would say it's definitely medium body on the attack, and it kind of goes along your mouthfeel. And I like how delicate it is, how beautiful the tannins are for this wine. And that's a wine that you can age for 2 to 3 years or even more. But the beauty of Fleur de Solène is actually the wine that you can actually drink right now, almost, you know, even with this texture. And that's what we'll shoot for. The finish is just velvety. Also, acid on the back, it can make you want to have another glass, you know, definitely. So I just love this wine. All right, Harmony is the last one on the list, 2019. So as most of you know, Harmony is definitely focused on Grenache. He has about 70% Grenache in it, with always Syrah and Mauvais. So we started this one in 2010, which the blend was very different. It was maybe a third of each. But we kind of very, as the years went, very specifically went and actually came back to that. It's very close to Châteauneuf-du-Pape style. We didn't make that in purpose. We kind of waited for all the sites that's going to be bringing to this wine what we'll do. But definitely, every year we go back to the same blend. About 70%, I think 19 has about 16% Mauvais, and the rest of Syrah, little less Syrah, because it kind of covers the Grenache. To focus on this wine, you can see the color, you know, very definitely light color, because Grenache is not in colors. But the reason I'm here behind those barrels is to kind of, one aspect is very important of this varietal, it's the vineyard. You know, of course, we like to have vines that age trained. And this year for the 19, we have about 50% from the estate, very happy about that, between the Mauvais, the Grenache, and a little bit of the Syrah, and the rest from other vineyards just behind us on Willow Creek AVA. And the second aspect is the barrel. You know, the Grenache is definitely a sensitive grapes in a way that to keep the freshness and the fruits, for me, for the style I want to reach, I want to have a barrel kind of protect that and not kind of covering that. So the protection comes with actually a little bit bigger barrels. So this barrel is about a 400 liter barrels. So we use definitely those are twice bigger than this one, this guy right here. That's about the 225. And with the size, it actually helped to protect the wine. You know, this wine will be much more oak influenced because it has much more oak into the wine. This one has double size, definitely twice less. So for the protection of that, can really kind of, I like that. It's like also have like thicker wood, which the oxygen doesn't go through as fast. And for the Grenache, I feel that very, very good. So we also have some older grape barrels for that. We use about 7 to 10 years barrels, not too much new. I would say 10% only into that blend, just to respect that, you know, fruit. So you can see definitely Grenache, it's so, you know, aromatically interesting and beautiful. We like also to have some stem. The stem kind of give you a little bit of the grip tannin, give you a little bit acidity, because if you chew a little bit of stem, it's kind of very tannicky and greenish, slash a little bit acidity. And that for the Grenache is really good because it kind of bring another element to the blend. You know, it's there on the juice, it's fresh, it's elegant, very fruity, but the good fruit, not the sweet fruits. And for me, the yolk doesn't come at all in it. It just, you know, make like a blanket into the wine, like a good one. Like, you know, it's really protecting and giving something to the wine that's just on the aging part. I would say that will age, you know, definitely a good decade, definitely. But if you want to open it sooner, like the Fleur de Solène, you can do a little bit of decanting. I will decant Fleur a little bit more, like maybe, you know, 5-6 hours before. But this one, like maybe a little bit less, like 3-4. I just love the mouthfeel in it. It's just like comes and going, definitely has layers. I'm very happy we have 50% fruit from the estate. That's pretty cool. So, all right, guys. So I think we talked about those four wines. I hope you will enjoy them. If you are going to join us on a virtual tasting we are doing on the 20th that we ship out next week, I'd be happy to see you. But if you are not part of this virtual tasting for the spring release, I think the allocation open on the 23rd, is a Tuesday. And you will be able to customize your shipments and between the four. Don't forget, we have 3 liters of Magnum for the rosé. We will have a couple of Magnums on Fleur and Harmony as well, as much as white. So we hope you enjoy. Thank you guys for the support and going to a good 2021, right? Thank you guys. Take care.